Hello everyone, I am Huawei instructor Li Xinyuan. We briefly explained the process. Now let's see how to configure our AC and AP on the web interface. This topology design still uses AYC direct connection for two-layer networking. It's the same as the topology we discussed in the previous session. So AP and STA, which are the gateways for our user terminal devices, all are on the AC. We use two logical interfaces, VLAN 100 and VLAN 101 are used as these two gateways. Then, because we are directly connected, so our traffic will definitely reach the AC first, then continue to enter our network. This data plan is the same as the previous lecture. We need to establish such templates. Then, you need to set up the AP group, bind the pre-configuration template with AP groups. Then bind the SSID template, security template, and VAP template together. Then the VAP template also needs to be bound to the AP group. Now, let's move on to the specific configuration in the web interface. First, we need to establish VLAN on the AC. Remember, we need to create two logical interfaces on this AYC. So, establishing these two logical interfaces is VLAN interfaces. So, we need to first establish two VLANs. First, enter the configuration, then click on AC configuration. In the VLAN option configured on the IC, then we can enter this specific configuration interface. Click VLAN, then select batch create. Why is it batch creation? Because we have two VLANs. So, batch creation can be used, then we can enter 100 and 101, use commas to separate in between. After inputting, click OK. So our VLAN has been created successfully. After creating the VLAN, then we can configure our physical interfaces. After we have created the VLAN, if these VLANs are not bound to physical interfaces. So this VLAN is ineffective. Now let's take a look at how to create it. Operate our physical interfaces, bind our VLAN to the physical interface. Similarly, in the AC configuration, just now we chose VLAN. Now we select Interface Management. In Interface Management, we choose the physical interface card. For example, if we want to operate the first interface, then we click on the first interface to enter. After entering, this is what the interface looks like. So here, we can choose the link type. This link type, on our AC device, configuration can be done using the command line, port link type trunk. So here, we can directly choose the type as trunk. Then the allowed VLANs are 100 and 101. Here we can see some advantages of our web interface. This web interface, we are graphical, very convenient. There is no need to memorize commands rigidly. After the establishment, click OK. Now, on our interface 1, allowed VLANs 101 to pass. Next step, we are going to set up our two VLAN interfaces. These two VLAN interfaces, a gateway. Serving as AP management, a gateway serving as the user's IP address. Similarly, still in the VLAN submenu, we choose VLAN if. Then select new. We need to create two. Let's create the first one first. VLAN 100. Enter VLAN 100 here. Then here is the MTU value. We can use the default one. Then this IPv4 is also the default. If we need to view it, hope our data becomes more accurate. When others are viewing, do you know what our VLAN is for? Then we can add a description here. For example, AP gateway. Of course. If we want to set it to something else, that's also possible. Then fill in our IP address here. There is also automatic masking. Just click OK. So we use the same method. You can also create VLAN IF101. Now our gateway has been set up. The DHCP service needs to be started next. So on our AC device, if using the command line, we need to use the command DHCP enable in the web interface. First, we need to select the IP in the AC configuration. Then we will have the configuration of the address pool here. First, the status of DHCP. We need to make sure it is on, that is, enable. Then select new. After selecting, we can select the interface address pool here. There is a difference between our interface address pool and the global address pool. Select interface address pool. In other words, only users coming from this interface. We will assign an address to him. Users from other interfaces, this address pool cannot be used. The interface selection is the VLAN IF100 that we just created. Then, the IP address of the interface has been determined. Finally, click OK. So our DHCP configuration is completed. For VLAN IF101, its configuration is also similar. Next step, we need to configure the AC power source address. What about this AC power source address? In the basic configuration of IC configuration, in the IC basic information, we can choose the type of AP source address using IPv4, then the source address. We can directly use an IP address as the source address. Of course, if needed, you can also use loopback or VLAN IF as the source address. Here we use 10.1.1.0.0.1 as the source address. Then click on this plus sign. This way, the address will be written to our device. Finally, click on Apply. Don't forget this step for sure. Changes will not take effect until the application is clicked. Now, moving on, we start dealing with AP. So just now in the AC configuration, configure. Now we are going to enter the AP configuration. Then the first thing to do is to set up an AP group. In AP configuration, we select the AP group, select New, create a new AP group. We set the name as AP Group 1, AP Group 1. Then click OK. In this way, we have established an AP group. After setting up the AP group, we need to add individual APs. How to add it? Add in the AP configuration. Select AP information, then select Add. After choosing this way, we will enter the following interface. Our way is to add manually. Then use the AP's MAC address to identify legitimate APs. So we can input the MAC address here, then set an AP name. If we set this AP ID, can also be set. If we take control, the system will automatically assign to us after setting select. Okay, so the AP has been added successfully. Then we go back to the AP information interface. Then we can see we have now added an AP. So our AP is now in the default group. We hope to place the AP in the group we just established, AP Group 1. How to proceed with the operation? Click to modify. Then we can select an AP group that we need to use, AP Group 1. Then click OK. In this way, this AP is added to the AP Group 1 group. So far, AP has come online and has been added to the group AP Group 1. Then we can return to the monitoring view, select AP. Here we can see the current status of the AP. This is normal, a green dot. This indicates that the status of this AP is normal. Our AP is now ready for immediate use. This group information is also correct. The AP is ready now. Now we need to configure the template. Bind the template with the AP. First, we need to go back to the configuration, then go back to the configuration of the AP. Here, we will see a template management interface. Then we can first create a template for SSID. Click on the SSID template, select New. We can create a template name, click OK. So now we have already established a template. In this template, we create the SSID name as employee, right here. This is the maximum number of users. Here you can also set to hide the SSID. This option, this is what I mentioned in the previous lecture just now, if we select this option, in other words, if the number of users for this SSID on this device reaches the maximum, then the newcomer won't be able to find this SSID anymore. After the setup is complete, select Application. So the template of this SSID has been configured successfully. After the template configuration of SSID is completed, we only need to configure the security template. The security template is also very important. Select Security Templates in Wireless Applications. Select New, the same template name. Then click OK. We are now using WPA, WPA2. This can be considered quite common. It's also very commonly used at home. It is also very common in some commercial settings of ours. It has relatively good security. We use PSK as the authentication method. Then select these two encryption methods, compatible with AES and TKIP. So WPA2 is also compatible with AES and TKIP. In the encryption type, we use passphrase. We set a password ourselves. Just knowing it by yourself is enough. Finally, click Apply. Configuration completed. Now we have the template for our SSID. The security template is also available. Then these two templates need to be bound to the VAP template. So we need to set up another VAP template. Similarly, choose the VAP template in wireless applications. Select New, set template name, and click OK. After the VAP template is created, so everyone should still remember. When we think of VAP templates, we should think of, we need to introduce four configurations into it, SSID template, security template. These two templates reference the two templates we just created. Then we need to configure our forwarding method. We can use tunnel forwarding. Then you also need to configure the VLAN ID. After all configurations are completed, we click on the application. The VAP template configuration is now completed. After the configuration is completed, we need to bind the VAP template with the AP group. Now let's take a look at where the AP group is located. Enter AP configuration, then select AP group configuration. In the AP group, we select the AP group we just created. In this AP group, after we click in, we can see the configuration of VAP. So in the VAP template list, we can choose to add. After adding, we can choose the template we just created, then use WLAN ID 1, RF use 012. All RF applications use this template. Finally, click OK. After the operation is completed, now we can take a look. If there is a user logged in, we can then check the online status of this user. Click on Monitoring. Click on the user. So here, then we can see a user. This is a username. Then he connected from AP1. Everyone can see that this IP address belongs to the 1.1.1 subnet. That is the subnet of the service we configured. The frequency band is 2.4G. There is some other information behind. So, in this way, users can go online normally. This indicates that our configuration has been successfully completed. In this chapter, I introduced everyone how to configure AC and AP through external methods. So here is one point that everyone should pay attention to. In our network setup, the gateway for our DHCP does not necessarily have to be on the AC. If our DHCP gateway is not on the AC, for example, the gateway for DHCP is on top of our core switch. So, for this situation, we need to be flexible and adaptable. So, in this case, we can no longer configure DHCP on the AC. So, this chapter comes to an end. We have now learned how to configure WLAN services. In the next class, we will talk about fault diagnosis. This troubleshooting is also very important. In our usage, various problems are inevitable. So we need to have such a methodology. Let's see how to eliminate the obstacles we may encounter. Then we will have a process, step by step. As long as everyone follows this process, most obstacles can be eliminated. So with this, it will be explained in our next class. Thank you, everyone.